Welcome to the onboarding tutorial for Transcriptive Rough Cutter. In this tutorial, we're going to go over the different areas of Transcriptive Rough Cutter so you know where to find stuff, but we'll leave deeper explanations for other tutorials. So let's get started. The first thing to know is the clip mode switch. If this is on, then Transcriptive is going to be looking at the project panel, and as you select different clips, it's going to show the transcript for that clip. If you have this turned off, it will be in sequence mode, and the transcript will be for whichever sequence is currently active. So as we switch to different sequences, it will load the transcript for that sequence. Next up is getting the transcript itself. Now, if you already have a transcript in text format, you can click on the import dialog, and you can import the transcript in a variety of different ways. But if you need to get a transcript, then you click on transcribe, and this will allow you to select which speech service to go with. Alignment is also here, so if you've imported a text-based transcript that does not have timecode, alignment will analyze the audio and add timecode to your imported text file. You can also select the language. Glossary allows you to type in names or terminology that the AI might not necessarily know, and it can definitely improve accuracy if you have a lot of terms that are maybe unusual. So transcribe dialog is incredibly important. The auto load button tells Transcriptive Rough Cutter to automatically load the transcript for whatever you click on. So if I'm down in the project panel and clicking on different clips, it's going to load that. If you want to lock it to just one clip, say you're using a sequence, turn on sequence mode, and no matter what we do, we want to always have this transcript shown, we can click on auto load, and that will do that. So as I move to different sequences, the sequence for Cap 7 is always shown. And of course, you can edit text. We can come down here, and it operates a lot like a word processor. We can just click on words and start typing away. We can, of course, start playing back. And you'll notice that every word has time code, so as I click on different words, it's going to move to different points on the timeline. And of course, we can change speakers by clicking on the speakers and selecting from the drop-down menu. And you can do other things like add comments or delete entire blocks of text or strike through them if you want. And of course, that brings us to the main menu where you can manage speakers. You can click on that. It will allow you to add speakers, change the name of speakers, and all that will then be reflected in the dropdown you see in the text edit window. Sync transcript to sequence edit is an important item. If you edit your sequence and delete stuff, it will become out of sync with the transcript. The transcript will have stuff that's no longer in your sequence. If you select sync transcript to sequence edit, Transcriptive will go through your sequence and rebuild the transcript to match what you've edited out. You can import Adobe transcripts from their new text panel. Of course, you can batch files, so if you have lots of clips that you want to get transcribed, batch is a very easy way of doing that. You have the preferences, the keyboard shortcuts, and of course your license. And down here you have the ability to export files, like a text file of the entire transcript. The Rough Cut button is a key feature of Transcriptive Rough Cutter. It will take a transcript that you have edited and build a sequence based on that transcript. So if you delete text, it will delete that portion of the clip or sequence from the new Rough Cut. So this is a feature that requires a bit of explaining, so I definitely encourage you to check out the in-depth tutorial on Rough Cut. And you also have the ability to search. Now, search is one of the most powerful features of Transcriptive Rough Cutter, along with Power Search, which is the other panel that ships with Transcriptive. Here, you can search the entire transcript that's in the Transcriptive Rough Cutter panel. You can also replace words. But the real power comes from Power Search, which can search the entire project. So if you're looking for something and you're not quite sure what transcript or clip it's from, you can type in the term and get a bunch of search results, much like any other search engine. And when you click on those results, it's going to open up that clip and jump right to where that happens. Click on these other ones, it'll work for sequences as well. And then when you load that up, that transcript will appear in Transcriptive Rough Cutter. And since there's nothing else like this anywhere in Premiere itself, this is a really powerful way of making use of your transcripts. If you'd like to share the transcript with another Transcriptive Premiere user, or even a transcriptive.com user, you can come up here to this T icon, and that's where you can start sharing the sequence or clip with another user. And then you have your job management list, which is all of the jobs that you've had done. You can reload them if you need to. And last but not least is the account menu. Here you can buy additional minutes, you can get to your account settings, and most importantly, this will take you to your dashboard. And that will show you all your charges, all your invoices, upcoming subscription payments, pretty much everything involving your account. So that's pretty much the onboarding tutorial. That's the basics. Like I said, we have lots of other tutorials that go in depth into all of these features, but just want to give you a kind of brief overview of where everything is at and where to find everything. So hopefully you enjoyed that. And like I said, definitely check out the other tutorials and you'll be up and running.